Good afternoon and welcome to St. Francis Xavier Parish as we celebrate the sixth Sunday of Easter. Our opening song is number 558. Come Christians, join to sing number 558.
Yeah. celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold on to in what we do through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
When Peter entered, Cornelius met him, and falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up, I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured out to the Gentiles also, for they could hear them speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit even as we have?" He ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
according to John.
Glory.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This past week on the formative website that some of you might follow, Dr. Tim Gray said that Mother Teresa used to tell her sisters, we're going to have to go out and do some work so that we can put smiles on those faces. And she had that connection of our service and our giving to others is what will bring us joy. And today Jesus makes a connection. He wants our joy to be complete. And then he goes on to speak about loving in a very self-sacrificing, self-denying way, to lay down one's life for one's friends. And yet perhaps there's a connection there if we want to be joyful. You know, and certainly Mother Teresa embodied that. Just about every picture you see of Mother Teresa, she had a beautiful smile. She really beamed, she glowed with joy, you know. And we're challenged to make that same connection. I was thinking of in my youth, and luckily we have older people here like me, so this might resound to some of you, but growing up, I was a big fan of the sitcom Taxi, with Reverend Jim Matowski and Alex Rieger and Louis De Palma, the whole gang in the taxi, the cab shop, you know. And there was one episode where Reverend Jim inherited a bunch of money, and he was giving it away left and right. Of course, Jim was a little off, you know. And Alex and the rest of the gang in the cab shop, Alex said, "Jim, you can't be doing this. This is insane." And he said, if you don't stop immediately, we're going to have you committed, and we're going to, put somebody in charge of your money." And Jim in his own way says, "Well, Alex, I'll tell you what. I'm going to give each of you $1,000, and your job is to give it away. And when you're done with it, if you still think I'm crazy, well, honky donkey." I love Reverend Jim. And of course, it was a wonderful episode where each one of the cabbies would encounter somebody who was in great need and recognize this is a person that really needs help. And it is such a joy and such a privilege to give this away to this person in need. And of course, the end of the story was they did not have Jim committed. But he gave them that opportunity to test this theory that it's when we give of ourselves we're going to receive the most joy. That kind of goes against our intuition. It's counterintuitive, you know? And it goes against everything that our culture stands for. You know, our culture tells us, look out for number one, take care of yourself. I always like to point out when I get together with old friends, we talk about old friends from the neighborhood, and somebody says, "Oh, he's doing very well for himself." I go, "Well, that's good. Is he doing well for anybody else?" Because that's what we're here for, and that's what we should strive for, you know, to do well for others. And so Jim gave the cabbies an opportunity to test it, and hopefully they learned a great lesson in that whole experiment. But that's something we're called to each and every day. You know, to put the Lord's words to the test. Check it out. Try it out. You know, to really go out of your way to reach out to somebody, to minister to somebody. Maybe it's Maybe it's showing mercy to somebody who's hurt you. Maybe for me, very often, it's just trying to be polite on the road. To that guy I don't like in front of me, you know, and just try to do it counterintuitively. Because really, that's how we fulfill our baptismal commitment. You know, when we were baptized, if you remember, we rejected sin. And we rejected Satan, the father of lies. And we rejected the glamour of evil and refused to be mastered by sin. And really wanted to be mastered by Jesus Christ, you know. So there's the chance for us. So today the formula is give of yourself, give to others. Lay down your life. And we do that in little ways, you know. Give people your time, your talent, your treasure, whatever they might need. And see if your joy then becomes more and more complete. Because that's what the Lord promises us today. Our joy will be complete if we simply fulfill his commands. And so let us stand. And we do profess our faith. I believe in one God, Father the Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us then and for our salvation,
and by the Holy Spirit, he was incarnate of the Virgin Mary in a human day.
For our sake, he was crucified by the righteous high God. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen.
Now we place before God our needs and the needs of our world.
For the church, that Pope Francis and all the church will be strengthened with every gift of the Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, that world leaders will share resources with the hungry of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish, that we may fulfill God's command to love one another as Christ has loved us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have been hurt by injustice and lived in hardship will find kindness and hope for a new beginning, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That God will guide us in taking care of the good earth so that we can live in peace with the birds of the air and the animals of the field, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Renew hope in those who are in prison and help us to extend compassion to their families and loved ones, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That we will work for social justice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That all the faithful departed may be joined with the angels and saints in heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the intentions of this Mass, the living members of the Altar and Rosary Society, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Hail Mary.
Jesus is our God.
Let's pray now that our gifts of bread and wine and the gift of our lives may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands,
for the praise of your holy name, for our good and the whole holy church.
May our prayers rise up to you, Lord, together with the sacrificial offering, so that, purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation at all times, to give you acclaim, Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. In him, the old order has passed away, and a universe cast down is now renewed, and integrity of life is restored through Jesus Christ. And so, overcome with paschal joy, and joining every land and people that exalts in your praise, even the heavenly powers and angelic hosts, we sing together the unending hymn of your glory. Jesus took bread and gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this
we offer you, Father, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. And humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, that we may be gathered into one by your Holy Spirit. And Father, remember your church gathered here and spread throughout the world, and bring us all to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Edward our Bishop and all who minister to your people. And remember, too, our loved ones who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Mother Mary and Saint Joseph, her spouse, and all of the apostles and saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we pray that we, too, might merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus taught us to call God our Father, so we are bold enough to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant peace in our days. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all distress and worry as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, and the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
And Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grant peace and unity in our days in accordance with your will. For you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Share that peace with one another.
Communion songs number 348, Taste and See, number 348.
Body of Christ. body of Christ.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go forth now glorifying the Lord by our lives.
Thanks be to God.
Have a good evening, everybody, and a good weekend. Be safe out there. Stay dry.
Our closing hymn is number 497, Love Divine, All Loves Excel, number 497.
To